Boeing has delivered its first MQ-25 Stingray to the U.S. Navy for testing on February 21st. Recognized as the leading carrier-based operational vehicle globally, this unmanned aircraft excels in aerial refueling, intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance (ISR) capabilities. With this delivery, the U.S. Navy has taken a key step towards overcoming refueling challenges for tactical fighters such as the F-18 Super Hornet and F-35. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the MQ-25 Stingray could be a game-changer for the U.S. Navy in the Indo-Pacific theater. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. China asserts its sovereignty over the entire South China Sea, despite facing rejection from the international community and dismissal in international courts. President Xi Jinping has chosen to utilize China's rapidly expanding military strength to impose its claims despite opposition. China has militarized several islands in the area and has even deployed advanced missile systems like YJ-12 anti-ship missile, as well as HQ-9 surface-to-air missile. The Chinese military has weapons that are specifically designed to counter the U.S. Navy. China has 2 missiles that are deployed to neutralize supercarriers or large warships, DF-21D and DF-26B. The Dongfeng-21 is a 2-stage, solid-fueled, single-warhead, medium-range ballistic missile, MRBM, that has a speed of around Mach 10, a maximum range of 1,450 kilometers or 900 miles, and carries a 600 kilogram or about 1,350 pounds warhead. DF-21D is the anti-ship variant. DF-26B, developed from DF-26, can hit naval targets. It has a range of 4,000 kilometers or 2,500 miles, and is thought to be designed to conduct precision nuclear or conventional strikes with an accuracy of 100 meters CEP. These missiles would make it risky for American supercarriers to operate in these waters, and they'll have to maintain distance. This, in turn, means the carrier-based aircraft will find it difficult to carry out their missions as they have finite fuel capacity. Boeing MQ-25 Stingray is an aerial refueling drone that resulted from the Carrier-Based Aerial Refueling System (CBARS) program. The primary role of the Stingray drones will be to provide crucial aerial refueling support to the Navy's carrier air wings. Additionally, these drones possess the capability to operate in a secondary role, undertaking intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance missions as needed. In October 2017, the U.S. Navy released the final MQ-25 Stingray RFP. The Navy's goal for the aircraft is to be able to deliver 15,000 pounds, that's about 6,800 kilograms of fuel total, to 4 to 6 airplanes at a range of 930 kilometers or 580 miles. The competitors were Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, General Atomics, and Boeing. Lockheed Martin put on the table their Sea Ghost design based on the RQ-170 Sentinel. Northrop Grumman initially proposed X-47B, but later withdrew, stating it wouldn't be able to execute the program under the terms of the service's request for proposals. General Atomics proposed the Sea Avenger concept, which is an enlarged version of the Avenger drone customized for air refueling. Boeing came into the competition with a full-fledged prototype derived from its Phantom Ray demonstrator, which ultimately won. The contract is worth $13 billion, as around 72 such drones will be inducted in total. Over the years, Boeing has been engaged in extensive testing of the MQ-25 demonstrator, referred to as T-1, bearing the U.S. Civil Registration Code N-234MQ. These tests formed a crucial part of Boeing's ongoing efforts to develop the initial production representative prototypes of the Stingray for the U.S. Navy. In 2021, T-1 successfully underwent integration into the carrier environment during a demonstration aboard the USS George H.W. Bush, CVN-77. While the MQ-25 design is less stealthy than a flying wing UAV, it does feature a stealthy fuselage shaping, a flush inlet to shield engine blades from radar, and a V-tail. Boeing's MQ-25 design is powered by one Rolls-Royce AE 3007N turbofan engine, delivering 10,000 pound force, or 44 kilonewtons, of thrust. This is a variant of the engine used to power the Navy's MQ-4C Triton. The MQ-25 has 15,000 pounds of fuel ready for offloading within an 800-mile or 1,290-kilometer range. It will significantly extend the combat range of deployed FA-18 Super Hornet, EA-18G Growler, and Lockheed Martin F-35C combat aircraft. Viewers may note that air-to-air refueling by default is a complex procedure where aircraft have to fly in close proximity, so refueling of a piloted aircraft by an unmanned tanker is a major technological feat. Additionally, the MQ-25s are expected to be integral in conducting intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance (ISR) missions for the Navy. The importance of the MQ-25's capabilities lies in its ability to tackle the inherent challenges posed by extensive distance in the Pacific region. By effectively doubling the range of tactical fighters, it offers a strategic advantage that has the potential to reshape the dynamics of aerial operations in the area. Upon becoming operational, these drones will autonomously operate from the decks of America's Nimitz and Ford-class carriers, meeting returning fighters to refuel them and extend their range. Chinese professional military circles have taken note of this remarkable capability, perceiving it as a potential game-changer in the context of Pacific theater operations. MQ-25 also fits perfectly in the larger scheme of things. The U.S. Navy is actively working to enhance the representation of unmanned aircraft on carriers, anticipating that air wings will predominantly consist of unmanned vehicles in the next decade. The Navy is aiming for a 40-60 split between unmanned and manned aircraft, with a long-term goal of achieving a 60-40 split in favor of unmanned vehicles.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.